Today, we're going to talk about one of the most common types of pain. In the U.S., it's the second most common reason patients visit their doctor. It's the number one cause of disability in people under the age of 45, and the third most common disability overall. What kind of pain are we talking about? Well, it's low back pain. Studies show that 70 to 90% of people have an episode of low back pain at some point in their lives. Of those, 80% will have a recurrent episode. Well, these are staggering statistics for a treatable problem. Why? Well, most adults with low back problems seek treatment for their primary symptom, that is the pain. Unfortunately, you can't just treat the pain. You have to first identify the source of the pain in order to correctly treat it to prevent a recurrence. Today, we're going to talk about the common causes or sources of back pain, how they occur, what the symptoms feel like, and what the best treatment option for each problem is. But now let's first take a look at the anatomy or the parts list of your back. When I talk about the anatomy or parts list of the lumbar spine, I like to talk about four categories. 1, 2, 3, 4. First of all, there is a column of bones that are called vertebrae. Column of bones that are called vertebrae. It is the last five bones or vertebrae that form the low back or lumbar spine. Secondly, there are some muscles. In fact, there are a set of muscles that attach on either side of this column to this bone called the ilium bone, which is part of what we call your pelvis. So there's a set of muscles here attaching to this bone, and a set of muscles here attaching to this bone that produce some support for this column. The third category is that of the joints. The joints are of three types. First of all, the facets. The facets are joints that connect these vertebrae in the back. Then there is the sacroiliac joint. The sacroiliac joint, which is this joint here and here, anchors this column or low back to the ilium bone or pelvis on either side. And finally, we have the discs. The discs are these shock absorbers that actually anchor these bones or vertebrae in the front. The fourth category is that of the nerves. The nerves comprise the electrical system of the spine, and there are two basic types. There is the spinal cord, and then branches of the spinal cord that are called the peripheral nerves. The spinal cord travels down the middle of the column, and the branches come out from either side from the spinal cord. In previous shows, we talked about abnormalities that cause pain in the muscles. We talked about abnormalities and problems that cause pain in the facets and the sacroiliac joints. Today, we're going to talk about problems in the discs and the nerves that can produce back pain. Let's look at a normal disc and nerve. And if we look at the front view of two vertebrae, there's one, stacked up on a second one like this. And between them is a donut-shaped structure that's called the disc. So this is a donut that sits between them. And it turns out that this is a jelly donut, so it has some jelly in the middle. Here's the jelly in the middle. Again, running through the column within the vertebrae is the spinal column. And exiting from that spinal column or spinal cord are those branches. Now let's look at an degenerative disc and pinched nerve. Here is the vertebrae. And now you'll notice that the vertebrae underneath it sits a little bit closer because the donut or disc has been kind of squished and compressed. And in fact, on this end, it's even ruptured. The jelly, in turn, has squirted out and accumulated out here to the side. Well, what's on the side also? That spinal nerve. And as a result, that jelly pinches against that spinal nerve, irritates it, and we get pain.